Hi everyone, I'm Sarah Famigno and welcome to the ClassPoint channel. You've joined us on a video today on Microsoft Teams' three newest updates in their Assignments tab. So this includes group assignments, return for revision, along with how to filter all of your assignments. So we're going to be giving you guys a step-by-step walkthrough of how to use each one of these new features. Before we get started, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications if you haven't already. That way you can stay updated with all of our ClassPoint tutorials and EdTech tips and tricks, including the tips and tricks on Microsoft Teams and Microsoft PowerPoint. Not only can you assign work to individual students in Microsoft Teams, but now you can assign a group of students a project or an assignment to work on together. So we can go through a step-by-step process of what this looks like and how to do it on the teacher side and the student side. So in your Microsoft Teams, the first thing you might notice is a little bit of an updated UI here on the side. So Teams has moved some of those most common side tabs up here down to the side so that it's just a little bit easier for you to access and a little bit more organized. So in our Assignments tab, we can go click Create and start a new assignment here. So let's just add in some details and we can provide some instructions and attach any documents that you might need to. So let's just upload an article for our students to read. We can give it some points, and now we need to assign it to our students. So here you can see you can do all or individual or group. So we're going to be focusing on group, but if you do need a little bit of help on this Assignments tab, we do have a tutorial video that is linked up above or in this description below. So we're going to click groups of students, and when you click that, a pop-up will appear to do your groups. So you can do this manually or randomly and have Teams do it for you. So we're just going to do manually to start, and then we'll go back and do randomly so you guys can kind of see how both of them are done. So from there, we can just click Create Groups, and you guys just need to click on students to put them in a group. If you have a long list of students, you can always search their name up in this bar here. And in addition, you can change the group name. So I'm going to give them a country for them to do their assignment on, and then we can just click Create. Once that first group is done, you'll see that it tells you how many students are remaining to be put into a group. So no students will be doubled up and be in two groups at once, which is very nice. So when you're ready, you can create a new group, and we will give this group a country, click on these two, and click Create. If you made a mistake, you can always go back and edit and add students to a group if you need to. In addition, you can always delete a group and restart if you need to. So before we create these groups, let's go back and actually do it and so that you guys can see it randomly. So we can click here, recreate groups, and click yes. It'll just discard the old ones and we can start again. So here we just need to enter the number of groups. So we're just going to do two, and it will tell you how many students will be in those groups. So now we can just click create, and it has done it for us. So you can go in and edit and change the name of these groups. And when everything is complete, you guys can just click done. And so that concludes most of our editing here. So now we can just assign it to our students. And now we can go check this out on the student side. So here on the student side, you see that they got their notifications that they have a new assignment. So if we go into the Assignments tab, we can click on that first assignment, the natural disasters, and they can open up the article to read it and attach any of their group work. So only one student will be able to submit the work for the group. So if one student did it, the other two won't be able to because somebody else in their group has already done it. So let's go here and attach some of the work that this student completed. And once that's all loaded, we can turn it in for our group. Back on the teacher side, we can go into the Assignments tab and click on that assignment to see who has returned. So even though student 2, who we were on before, did turn in the assignment, if I click on student 1, that same PowerPoint will be pulled up because they all turned it in together, even though only one person did the actual turning in. So here you can look through their work and give them some feedback and some points. So you can do this as a group, or you can choose to grade the students individually here. And that way you can give each student some feedback and a separate points if you know that somebody did a little bit more work than the others. We're just going to keep it as grading students as a group here. And when you have all of the feedback put in, you can also assign them some points. So these students actually didn't do everything that I asked. So now this brings us into update number 2, which is returning work for revision. So before in Teams, you could only return work to students and they could resubmit it if they made any changes. So now you can actually give them a little bit more direction on what needs revising, and then they can turn it in again before the due date. So here we can go, instead of clicking return, we can do return for revision. So that way my students will know, okay, there's something for me to change before my final grade. So here on the student side in our activity, we can see that, okay, our assignment has been returned for revision. So now we can view this and view that feedback that my teacher left me. So our feedback is here and I can say, okay, let's change up what we need to do. I can attach a new document and maybe I just remove the old one so that my teacher knows that we did do some changes. So once that's all done, we can turn it in again for our group. And now back on the teacher side, we can go through and see that, okay, our students did do a revision again. Then you can also view the feedback right from here. So if we go to view it, we can say, okay, they did do what I asked. I can get rid of this feedback and say, great job, and give them the correct amount of points. And then I can return it for them to be done. The last little update that Teams has for the assignments feature is in the assignments tab, you get a list of all of your assignments throughout every team that you have. So this is good for teachers who have many classes with many different assignments. So here you can see that you can now filter it by all the classes, or you can choose to go into one of your different class teams and look specifically at those assignments. In addition, you can always search up a class if you have a long list. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video on Microsoft Teams' newest updates. We know that these features have been highly requested, so I hope that you guys find use for them in your classroom. Don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on notifications. That way we can keep producing videos for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.